Good evening, and welcome to our live stream, live from Zurich, Switzerland. Guten Abend und herzlich willkommen zu unserem Livestream aus Zürich. Wir haben heute ein halbes Dutzend Stück für euch. We have a half dozen compositions we'd like to play for you. And the first one is called A Wish for the Displaced. This piece was composed in 2015 as a response to the migrant situation from the Middle East and other situations around the world. We believe that there should be a life in peace and dignity for people who have been displaced from their place of origin, and that the countries that are in a position to welcome them should do so. So this piece is written in that spirit, A Wish for the Displaced.
Thank you.
That piece was called A Wish for the Displaced. Several years earlier, actually about 20 years earlier, I was in a different phase of my compositional life, and I was interested, living in New York at the time, in a process called comprovisation, something I called comprovisation, that is composed improvisation. What we played for you now is completely notated and requires utmost precision and concentration of a kind to really stay exactly together. But in the late 90s, I was feeling more like, let's stretch this out a little bit. Let's have some fun. Let's not worry about necessarily even what key we're in, or maybe even always the beat. Let's just have some ideas that are going to guide us through the piece, and let's meet at those ideas every once in a while, but then let's like go for various walks in various groups and, you know, come back and report what we found. So this piece is called Arrival of the Crows, and 1998 was the year of its composition. I think there's a slide that will tell you about the Arrival of the Crows itself, so I think we should just play it for you, Arrival of the Crows. Thank you. Arrival of the Crows. Now we're going to change into another mode. We're going to play a new piece for you. This is its premiere, these live streams. And I'm going to try to head through here without falling off the edge of the stage and go over to the drum kits. Which are waiting for us on our side stage number one. Okay. So this next piece is called The Third Degree. Give someone the third degree is to tell them off. But it's also the third degree because, well, after many years of playing Siamese kits, and having a couple of drum pieces, solo pieces under my belt, I thought I would attempt a three drum set piece. So the idea here is not that we have any soloists, but that we're actually one large drum set. In some cases, I mean, it could be said that also the pocket orchestra is one large drum set, but here we mean it pretty literally. The third degree is influenced by West African Ghanaian beats, one in particular in the first movement. And then also in the third movement, there are three movements to this piece, New Orleans second line drumming, the third degree. Thank you. Thanks, guys. That was a lot of fun.
Third degree. We gave it the third degree.
Let me get lined up here for this next piece. Put the main switch on. I always find it works better when you do that. Okay, let's see here. So this next piece is an intermedia improvisation, and it is being performed at these live streams for the first time. It's called The Boat of Queen Mutemwia. When I was in London a couple years ago, I went to the British Museum, and I was in the Egyptian collection there. I've always found it a wonderful place ever since I was a kid. And I noticed a piece that I hadn't really ever seen, had never really come to my attention before in the midst of all this grand, pharaonic splendor. So what it was is it was a little statuette, maybe about the length of this piano and the same width. And there was a woman seated in this boat, but she was cut off at the torso just by, you know, some accident or act of war, who knows, within the 3,000 years of its existence. And something about this boat just really spoke to me, even though you couldn't see the top half of this woman. And so I started reading. Well, first I was walking around it, looking at all these mysterious sort of totemic emblems all around it. So then I read the British Museum's research caption, and it said, these are the emblems of the spirits of art and music. So then I started to spin my fantasy about this, you know, and I thought, wow, so is she sailing off into the underworld? Is she, you know, is she dead? Is she going into the underworld, into this world of, you know, perpetual black and white shadows? And yet she's comforted and accompanied by the spirit of art and music, and somehow protected by them. So for the past couple of decades, I've been interested in working in intermedia. And by that, I mean the connection between visuals and music. And at various times, with various degrees of rigor or just simple poetic inspiration, I've tried to, you know, either link directly, technically, the sounds to the image being generated. And lately, I've been taking more freedom and also just going with, you know, impressionistic designs, in which I've been helped greatly by the lead programmer Nathan Wolick and the assistant programmer Adrian Scherer. So we're really a team of three, and in fact Adrian will be improvising the visuals live with me now for this piece, The Boat of Queen Mutemwe.
Thank you.
Okay, so now we have changeover from the intermedia piece back to the pocket orchestra. We're going to play two more pieces for you there. Let's see. We had asked if anybody had any questions, and I see some friends from near and far. Hi, Alex. Hi, Frank. Hi, Heidi. Hi, Heine. Let's see, we have a question. Love the real-time push two effects, Virgil. You're giving lots of ideas. Hi, Cliff from England. What Cliff is talking about is, let's see if there's anything else around. Nope. What Cliff is talking about is that there are various clips of music, little moments of music that can be triggered on the pad that I was working with. So you can put in the kinds of things you think you might like to have and you might like to mix and work together with. And they can be filtered, they can be slowed down, they can be transformed in any number of ways. So all the sounds that you heard just now, just about everything was created on the spot, was mixed together on the spot. I mean, of course, the sounds were programmed beforehand to the extent that they can be. For example, on a modular synth, an analog modular synth, it doesn't have any memory to speak of. But these things were mixed together, and the improvisational aspect, just like in Arrival of the Crows, was that, by the way, I'm not sure where I'm supposed to be looking. Are you here? Okay. The general shape is planned, but not the way it actually goes. And I just want to underline again that the visuals are being created in real time. So with the exception of some of the clips inside the piano that you saw, and some photographs, a couple of photographs that were mixed in, even those were being mixed in real time, and it was supposed to be, a jam between visuals and music. So, in case you may not have noticed, I'm basically vamping here, and the reason is, we've got to get that electric piano up from the intermedia piece back up here on stage for the Pocket Symphony. Let's see, is there anybody else I didn't say hi to? No? What effects did you use on that push two? As we say in America, I'll plead the fifth on the grounds that I might incriminate myself, because having said that I use effects on the push two, I use lots of effects on the electric piano. And actually, I think the only thing I used was when I was playing with the samples and putting together the piano sounds, I did a modulation inside of push. But we might get kind of technical here. I do see that we have at least one professional Ableton expert here. So, but the rest of you might not be that interested in that. It's just that you can take sounds and transform them inside, and you can hack them into pieces that that make a new rhythm. It was totally different from last night, says Jazz and Blue Project. The visuals were on another level. Well, Nathan and especially Adrian will be glad to hear that. So I guess if you saw last night and you watched tonight as well, you can see that things are going differently than yesterday. The drum piece had a different energy. And the concert's not yet over. But we are, in fact, compromising. In fact, I also thought the Arrival piece had quite a different shape than it did yesterday, the second piece we played. I don't see a thumbs up, but are we ready over there, Philippe? There's a thumbs up. Okay, let's head on up for the Pocket Symphony. So, quick word about the Pocket Symphony. Like the Third Degree and the intermediate piece, The Bodo Queen with Hemwia, this is a first. These pieces are being played here for the first time because I just finished writing them. I finished the intermediate piece on Monday, I think, and the Pocket Symphony a couple of weeks ago.
drum piece sometime in February. The Pocket Symphony is dedicated to my closest family, my wife Micheline, who's doing the lighting tonight, as well as our children, John and Julia, who are here somewhere. And let's see, it's a symphony, you know, so it's in four movements, as classical symphonies are. I wouldn't really call it a classical piece. It has various influences in it. It's, you know, music, it's nonverbal. So let's just play it for you. Pocket Symphony.
Thank you. Thank you.
That was Pocket Symphony. This next and final piece is called Detroit Per Se. I actually wrote it once I had returned to Switzerland, where I grew up. I'd been a professor out in the Midwest for a few years, living near Detroit. And, you know, Detroit was a town that was really down and out when I was there in the early to mid 2000s. And at the same time, there was a really vital underground art scene happening. And it was really amazing what was going on under the radar, which is kind of like our theme tonight as well, you know, under the radar, happening despite Corona. And art was happening in Detroit despite all the urban decay. So it was a really very, very productive and interesting time to be there. You know, Detroit has a large, has a lot of history. Industrial history, you know, the car industry, rock and roll energy like the MC5, Iggy Pop, you know, emblematic groups of American rock and roll. So I wanted to draw on that because I have a past as a rock drummer playing in, you know, hardcore bands, funk bands, rock bands. And so I wanted to draw on that energy. And at the same time, I was all thinking about, you know, Motown and the whole idea that Berry Gordy had to have like a factory, a hit factory, you know, just this idea of churning out the music, churning out the cars, churning out the music, and just that intersection of the industrial grit and the musical grit, you know, and just the culture that it forms. So Detroit Per Se, here it is.
Thank you.
Detroit, per se. We got a little gritty there. A little industrial, maybe. Nah, gritty. And, you know, industrial in a Detroit kind of way. So that concludes our second live stream. We've had a tremendously good experience here in the studio. We just have to say it once, that we really wish that you all could have been here live. But we felt your presence very much. Thanks for all your comments. Thanks for all of you who have tuned in. It's been a really wonderful experience for us to continue working. Circumstances have forced us to put together an entirely new group because it's very difficult to travel right now. And I've been very, very, very blessed, I have to say, to find such a wonderful group of people. And before we leave you tonight, I'd like to introduce you to everyone. So if I could first introduce the musicians briefly and then ask the crew to make their way onto the stage as well. Philippe? So on electric piano, we have the absolutely wonderful Mr. Philippe Schlotter. On piano, Mr. Luca Fries. On electric guitar, Mr. Simon Rupp. On drums, Manuel Pasquinelli. Fridolin Brumer. On bass, Anthony Burkhardt, bass clarinet and clarinet. Stefan Rolli, baritone saxophone and soprano sax. And Mr. Christian Bucher on vibraphone. Gregor, are you here? Please come up on stage. We have two more members. Adrian, also please. Two more members, actually, of this group. Mr. Gregor Lieser, who was the third drummer in the third degree. And Mr. Adrian Scherer, who's been an unbelievable assistant to this whole project, running around helping everybody, the video streamer, the audio guy, being my personal assistant, moving stuff around the clock. Really, really wonderful. And now I'd like to ask the other people too, please. Micheline for lights, and Chris. And Joshua, can you join us, or do you have to stay at the controls? He's going to stay at the controls. Well, the very capable professional Joshua Bürer from Vienna, from Biel, don't quite know what to call it, has been leading our live stream. And Farshad, you are operating the camera, so I guess I can't ask you to come up either, but Farshad has been helping, has been the video operator. And these two people have really helped bring this experience across to you on the smaller screen, on the virtual presence. And without them, we wouldn't be able to come to you at all. Mr. Chris Diegelmann has worked also tirelessly round the clock to bring you a high fidelity mix. Everyone here has been absolutely wonderful to work with. Last but certainly not least, Micheline Moorefield, my wife, who did the lighting. Let's see, is anyone else that I leave out? Because sometimes I can make that mistake. I don't see anyone else here but you two guys. So I just want to say a heartfelt thanks to all of us, to all of you for the support that you gave us, and to all of us for being such a wonderful team. Truly, it's been a wonderful experience, and I thank you all very much. Good night. Ha, 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 ha.